Hello, today I'm going to show you how to create this pattern. Let's open a new document, change the stroke to none and the fill to red. Now press the letter M for the rectangle tool and draw a square. Next, open the transparency window. If you can't see it, go to Window and choose Transparency. Now change the opacity to 50%. Go to View and make sure your smart guides are turned on. Next, switch to the selection tool, click on the square and let's duplicate it. Be sure both squares are aligned and there is no gap between them. Let's select everything and create a copy. We will use it later. Now select the first two squares and then go to Pathfinder and choose Unite. Next, press the Ctrl and C keys on your keyboard to copy it and Ctrl F to paste it in front. With the top rectangle still selected, hover your mouse over one of the corners, hold and drag to rotate it by 90 degrees. Now select both rectangles, open the Align panel, make sure Align to Selection is checked and choose Horizontal Align Left and Vertical Align Top. With both rectangles still selected, press the Ctrl and G keys on your keyboard to group them together. And we are finished with the first pattern piece. Next, we will create a slightly different piece. Let's move this square aside. Swap the fill and the stroke and change the color to black. Now we will create these stripes. First, press the letter P for the pen tool and draw a line from this anchor point to this one. Switch to the Direct Selection tool and click on this anchor point. Now extend the line. Be sure the On mark next to the cursor is showing to keep the same angle. And let's do the same with the opposite corner. Now open the Stroke panel and increase its weight to about 14 points. With the line still selected, go to Object, choose Repeat and select Grid. Zoom out and switch to the Selection tool. Let's adjust the horizontal spacing in Grid by dragging the tab widget left or right. Now bring the handles closer to show only the lines that are overlapping the shape. If you wish, adjust the spacing a little bit more. We can do this by using the horizontal spacing in grid window from the top toolbar. With the black lines still selected, go to Object and choose Expand. And repeat this one more time. Now select the black shapes and the square, and then go to Pathfinder and choose Divide. Finally, we need to delete all black shapes, leaving only the red stripes. To do this, select the Magic Wand tool. Click on one of the black shapes and then press the Delete key on your keyboard. And do the same with the remaining empty shapes. Let's bring this group of stripes to align with the other square and group it together. Now create a copy and rotate it by 90 degrees. To change the stripes orientation, press the letter O for the Reflect tool and then hit Enter. Set the axis to the vertical position and click OK. Finally, select both shapes and align them to the top left corner. Let's group them together. Now we are ready to create our pattern. First, open the swatches panel and drag this shape into it. You will notice the new pattern swatch. Double click on it to open the pattern options window. Now make sure the title type is set to grid and the width and height are the same. Let's repeat the same steps with this shape. Select everything and delete it. We won't need it anymore. Now bring the fill to the top and draw a rectangle. Open the swatches panel and click on one of the pattern swatches we've created. Now we can create different shapes and apply our pattern to it. To scale the pattern, first make sure the shape is selected and then press the letter S for the scale tool or select it from the toolbar panel. Now press Enter. Be sure the Transform Objects option is unchecked. We only need to select the Transform Patterns option. Now highlight the number in the uniform window and using the up or down arrow keys on your keyboard, adjust the size of your pattern. To change the color of our pattern, first select your shape and then choose Recolor Artwork from the top toolbar. Now drag the handle to choose a desired shade. If you wish, change the scale like we did previously. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.